So I'm measuring the time it takes for these three pendulums to swing from one side to the other and then back again. And I'm using my pulse to measure that. And so I'm gonna count the pulses of my heart to determine how it swings, because this is the way Galileo, when he first discovered the pendulum, did it. He would count his pulses because that was the reliable way to time things. Because before pendulums, you couldn't time things. And if you're going to discover a pendulum, you can't use what it's for to discover itself. So this one's the shortest, and so I think it will swing. It'll take the least amount of time. This one will be in the middle between these two. Well, I mean, it is. And this one will take the longest. So let me time them. So this takes three pulses to get to here and here and then back again. This one, let me measure it. This one takes two pulses. This one takes one pulse. So my hypothesis was correct. The shortest one takes the shortest amount of time. The one in the middle takes the median amount of time, and this one takes the longest. So, to improve this, I could get a better source of measuring time, and so a stopwatch would work to measure time, and that would allow me to determine exactly how long it takes in the standard time measurement. So the shortest one took the shortest amount of time, the longest one took the longest amount of time, and the middle one took the middle amount of time. So that's how a pendulum works, and yeah.